What is up, everyone? Welcome to a brand new review. We're talking about the brand new indie film, Lady Bird. I've been waiting to see this film for months now, and finally I've gotten my hands on it. Finally, a theater came near me to finally go and see this film, and let me tell you, this is easily one of the best films of this year, and I will be shocked if Saoirse Ronan does not get nominated this year for Best Actress, and if the director, Greta Gerwig, does not get nominated for Best Director, because this film is phenomenal. And I say that because this film is different. You know, this is just another coming-of-age film, where something of like an Edge of 17 that we got last year, Lady Bird excels in another dynamic with the coming-of-age. Doesn't just copy the same formula, it excels in a different way, where it's more of just the telling of someone's life. It's just their everyday lives, what they go through. And the thing about this film is that Greta Gerwig wrote and directed these characters so well because you care about each character. You start to love and fantasize about them. When the film ends, you kind of get sad, but you want to spend more time with these characters, which was really interesting to see of how attached I got to each character within the hour and a half runtime of this film. I think that's monumental triumph from the director of here, but it's also thanks to the actors and actresses portraying each character. Saoirse Ronan as Lady Bird in here, she's awesome. She's fantastic. When she debuted last year in Brooklyn, I knew she was going to be a star, and she's easily becoming one of my favorite actresses in Hollywood right now. She is so damn good in here, and like again I said, I would be shocked if she's not nominated, at least. She is one of my favorite performances this year, and she plays such a unique, quirky vibe to her Lady Bird character that you can kind of relate to in a weird way. At least I could, because I have some of those personalities that she does, and it's really cool to see where her life goes, because like I said, this isn't a huge, extravagant story. It's just a senior in high school getting ready to go to college, and what dynamics she has with her friends, her family, and especially her mother. I just say Laurie Metcalf, who plays her mother, is fantastic in here. Off the charts awesome. And again, I might be butchering these names. I'm really bad with names, but seriously, I have to claim her. Lucas Hedges also shows up in here, which he made his acting debut back in Manchester by the Sea, and I thought he was fantastic in there. And again, he's great in here as well as a more supporting role again. I thought he did a good job in here. I still think Manchester's a better positioned role for him, but I don't think his character's written. Mainly the main star is Saoirse Ronan. And I have to say, as big as the star she is, it's also Greta Gerwig, who is the director of this film. She's the star of this film. It's the way that she decided to tell this story, of focusing more on the characters than the stuff going around them. And that's what makes this film so great. It's not super funny. I didn't laugh out loud at a lot of scenes, but I still laughed throughout the movie. I enjoyed myself. I smiled. I got emotional towards some parts. And everyone, I think, can find a way to relate to this movie, whether it be Lady Bird's character, or maybe Lucas Hedges' character, or maybe even other friends and family that Lady Bird encounters in here. There's someone that we can all interact with and either remember from our past high school life. If you are in high school, then maybe interact and maybe get into that life. Because like I said, that's the one thing I love about this film, is how relatable I could feel to this film, and how I cared so much about these characters that I didn't want the film to end on that level. On the con side, I don't really have many cons. This film is pretty much perfect. The pacing, everything about this film is great. Maybe I would have kind of wanted quite a few more laughs, but maybe that's not what the director was going for, and I don't think that's what she was going for. But overall, I really enjoy Lady Bird. I cannot wait to watch this film again, and I really enthusiastically support that you guys go and check out Lady Bird, especially because it's starting to roll out more wide release, so I think you guys should be able to find it soon. With all that said, I'm gonna have to give Lady Bird an A. Really enjoyed Lady Bird, guys, and I'd be surprised if this film was not in my top 10 of this year. I absolutely adored Lady Bird. The performances, the direction was all great. But what did you guys think? Have you guys checked out Lady Bird yet? Have you not? Comment down below and tell me where your excitement level for it. Are you excited to see it? Are you not? Have you seen it, and what are your thoughts of it? That's what's important here, guys. I love having a lively discussion down below, especially when you guys all join in and start talking to each other. It's all great, because this is what we do here on this channel. We love talking movies. But of course, guys, if you're new here, make sure to hit that like and subscribe button. Never miss a video on my channel. I do tons of reviews, guys. Tons of new reviews coming out. I'm going to try and do the Three Billboards movie this week as well. No promises on that. I do have a busy week, because I do work in retail, so, and I did survive Black Friday. I survived. But guys, of course, make sure to, again, comment down below and let me know your thoughts. Make sure to go hit Sandwich John websites down below, guys. I love being a part of this team, and I hope you guys go check us out down below. But guys, of course, until next time, stay classy and have a great rest of your day.